Yo, what's going on, guys? Mike the Outsider back in the video. Today we are back in another game. This time we're playing automation / Beam.NG. Trying to build a flying car. And for the help of this, I've downloaded some mods. Maybe this car will work. Actually. Well, one of the default ones. I don't think I've tried this one. But pretty much we want anything that's rear engine. So that way, all the weight, or as much weight as possible, is in the rear. So when we hit something that can help us possibly fly, we can go, wee, you know, up into space. And so, yeah, I have done this multiple times. And I got this video idea from AR12 Gaming. Nick tried it, and I was very intrigued by it and wanted to see if I could do it myself. Let's see what kind of engine is going to fit in here. This may not work for what I want. Yeah, okay, can I go back to car selection? Okay. Shit. Let's see, what else could I maybe try? I mean, maybe I could try front engine. Or actually, no, let's go back to what we were just trying to do. We'll make it mid. Like mid engine. So it's not in the front, and it's perfectly displaced in between. Can I fit a V16 in here? Oh, heck yeah. Probably about there, yeah. Yep, built steel because it's the lightest. There, we'll leave all this here for now. Change it as needed. Make it a turbocharger. Give it. Is that where a cooler is supposed to go? I don't think that's where intercooler is supposed to go. I could be wrong. But for this, yeah, sure. I'll say that's normal. I gotta go back and make this thing slightly shorter. There we go. This looks normal. That's fine. Wait, single player echo makes it even smaller yet? Let's go. Get it to 100% fill exactly. Then click this a bunch. There we go. Instantly just knocking. Why? Probably because of this over here. Nope. No. What was that? 57.8.4, right there. And then starts knocking. Naturally aspirated. It decreases a bunch of stuff, but you know, makes you feel a lot smaller. So you can go back. If I make a V10 instead. Or V12 this way? Nope. V10 is like the perfect one. Just because. Look at it. This is why not many V16s exist. And knocking. Oops. There we go. Oh my God, stop knocking, car. Is this just a fail? Oh. Oh, that increased it a lot. Okay, this changes nothing. And it starts knocking. But it means I can lower this slightly until it starts knocking again. This is a balancing act that I don't like. But for flying car science, it's worth it. Oh yeah, that looks good. Okay, can. Alright, I can raise this up actually. I want as close to 1,000 horsepower in this as I can. And knock. Nope. This is the sweet spot right there for all that. Okay. Up the fuel mixture a bit. As much horsepower as possible. Update ignition timing. Hopefully don't just break. RPM limit. 1,000 horsepower plus baby. Barely over 1,000. But it's over 1,000. That's all that matters. Let's listen to this engine roar. Y'all ready for this? Yay, Dimble. Gonna do some body molding on this, if possible, of course. Yeah, that works. Let's see. Yeah, that's kind of like an airplane wing. that as sloped as possible, make that as sloped as possible. Yeah, this looks fine. Make that as long as possible, so. Yeah. Oh, what have I done? I don't mind this though. And we're gonna make this white. Because, like, every airplane is white. There we go. Now, to make this box less of one, I guess. See, we have a bunch of mods here. Oh. I need this extended all the way across. Make it giant like that, yeah. Make it. No, that's too much angle though. That's downforce though. We need upforce. Or I could just make it a flat sheet. No, that's getting deleted. Maybe, you know, it would help if I like. What if I move it down? No, it still wants to do that? Okay. What other wings do we have? I could use a snow shovel. Not doing it for me either. Yeah. Oh yeah, that works. Oh, that. That works. Oh, that. That's doing something for me. So it's like 3 in the morning for me. So yeah, it's 3:30 for me right now. Okay, I'm gonna scale this back a bit for now. You know, maybe about there is fine for now. We'll come back to that. That we need some mirrors. You'll see why I did that in a second. Let's see what are some wing like looking mirrors. These, since they have like carbon fiber on them. Where can I put them? Oh. Well. Yeah, that. This is fine. Yep. Nothing wrong with this. Then I put these ones up here, like so. Nope, don't need them wider. Just need them longer, mainly. Yeah, airplane. Oh yeah, oh yeah, windows. Duh. Can't have an airplane without windows. Come on. There we go, window. Just for the lucky passengers. Oh, you can't put one on here. Alright, hold on. There's one last thing that will help with airflow while we're flying, you know? Gigantic exhaust. Like, I mean, oh no. Gigantic. Yeah. So why don't I try that with this one as well? Looks good to me. Alright, which one is the least amount of weight? Just regular manual? Alright. 7 ratios. Top speed 318, yep. Gonna about 30 spacing. Do that. That looks fine. Why do I have to click to make everything move? Actually, no, we should want. Yeah, because this helps fill in the gaps of the everything. But we want thin tires. And I want mini tires. See, small tire diameter equals better weight, or less weight. There we go. Don't think it'll get off the ground, but you know. Think I might need to. Yeah, that looks fine. Just need giant rims. Wait, hold on. Speaking of that, I have to go back in here actually. Wheels. Something that completely like covers the actual wheel. Close. Yeah, that works right there. Looks fine to me. That would make them cheaper. Oh, don't worry, they're gonna be carrying aerospace. less drag the better. Less weight the better. Oh, this car is a death trap. Car, hopefully airplane, but. Race. Front tires blew out. Oh well. I don't care. It's so stupid, I love it. I wanna look at it on a test track real quick. Okay, maybe I can't. Okay, I have to actually try and get off the ground, so. There, I'll make a little bit bigger, better tires. There you go, game. This seems fine, yep. Alright. Once again, I want to take it to the testing track. I mean, 3,000 pounds, 293 horsepower, top speed. Safe car, yep. Export to another game. Car. Then we're gonna try this on Beam.NG and see how it performs. Now we're gonna boot up some Beam.NG launch game. That is not what I wanted to do. Okay. Then we're gonna take it to Cardiff Arena, where all the best tests happen, by the way. Especially for flying vehicles. Then we scroll down and find it. Here it is, flying car. We replace current. Oh god. Yeah, these are gonna get knocked off probably. Well, they survived. This is so funky looking. Alright, should I just send it? Alright, gonna send it in 3, 2, 1. Fly! It kind of flew. Perfect. Let's do this again. Oh, what just broke off actually? That wasn't important, don't need it. Fly. See, it kind of floats once you, like, hit something. Alright, hold on. Let's take this to a different map. No, what map would be good for this? You know what? Let's just take it to regular grid map. So I can try and find like the ramps, you know. Go wee. Alright, once again, get our flying car out. Where are the jumps I need? I don't really know. Here's one over here, actually. See, this thing can turn. Somewhat. Blast off. No, my wing! That didn't work. Well, let's go and find a new one. That won't kill us, maybe. What about you? Actually, it killed everything. And... Swoosh. No, it's a wedge. One last round, maybe. Actually, I think I found it. thing's kind of a good drift car. Okay, can this go up it without taking my expensive wing? Yes. Well, we tried, I failed, maybe back for it though. Anyways, if you guys did enjoy, this is Mike the Outsider saying peace, have a great rest of your day. And also, hit that like button, subscribe if you're new, and hit that notification bell to get notified when I upload. And let me know in the comments what you want to see me do next. Anyways, bye bye!